What's up, guys? Welcome to day 28 of a year in my life, and I'm going to jump right into it. Today's a busy work day. I've got three clients in the office, and one of them came in to pick up this beautiful thing. I can't show them who they are, but I'm going to show the opening of the box so you guys can see what it is. Don't stab yourself with that, please. My client's like playing with knives and the little hatchet over here. If he stabs himself, it's not on us, it's on him. This is the Patek Philippe 5981R on a bracelet in rose gold with a blackish, grayish gradient dial. Retail on this piece is just over $100,000. In today's market, they sell for about $270 to $280. So crazy good pieces. And I think this is next up in line to be discontinued. When they do, this will be a 325 to 350 watch all day long. So for any of you guys out there looking for an investment piece in the six-figure range, this is a solid one to pick up right now.
Patek cheaped out on the watch. I said, all right, we're done. Oh, we forgot to figure out how to size the bracelet. Ah, still pins in it.
All right, guys. So I also wanted to show you one thing is that these two gifts right here are about to go out. This is the Rolex 116234 Datejust 36. That my winner in Malaysia won from the day six video. And this is the Mont Blanc backpack. Both of these are gonna get shipped out. These are the guys that went and shared the videos. They liked them, they commented, posted them on another social media platform and were chosen at random. Well, I told you guys I'm doing that again. And the next watch up for grabs is this Rolex Submariner, reference 16610. This is the pre-ceramic date Submariner, and I'm giving this away when I hit 20,000 subscribers. So guys, if you want to enter to win this watch, all you've got to do is share this video on another social media platform, come back to my channel, comment on this video below, and let me know where you shared it, and make sure you're subscribed to the channel. And when I hit 20,000 subscribers, one of you lucky guys is going to win this, so good luck.
Yes.
Alright. We're about to film a badass commercial that I cannot talk about yet. You guys will just have to wait till we release it. But it's pretty exciting, the newest thing we've got going on. It's gonna be huge for our business in the form of advertising and marketing. So we're gonna film this commercial, guys, and I'll be right back. And Alfred's on his way over to come meet me, and then we're headed to the airport to head to LA. Right. You're taking this for the weekend?
Yes. Okay.
Darby's obsessed with this watch, so we're going to sell his diamond one, and he's going to wear that one of mine while I'm gone. Dip the water into it. For the gallon for the day. Here's batteries for all those cameras.
Okay.
Take all this.
You actually gonna use mics on this trip?
I take them just in case, but probably not. Dude, there's such a hassle to like pull out and put on.
Yeah.
It's just so much easier to pull my phone out like on a whim, which is why I kind of like it, that I'm shooting everything solely on the phone, because these in here, I like it like that because whenever you get too good at the filming and the editing's too good, it sets an expectation where if I only ever film on my phone and it's always like third person vlog style and the following grows to that, people are okay with it. Ignore the mess, guys. I'm in a hurry.
Just remember, the more B-roll you get, the more music little music sections you can have.
Where are you going to show her?
Where are you at?
The Crescent.
The Crescent. Come to my apartment. I'm leaving in 7 minutes.
Yeah, I know. I'm leaving right now.
Okay.
All right.
Bye-bye. Okay, I'm going to have Darby run it by to you. I'm rushing out the door right now to get to the airport. So once he finishes at my place, he'll run it by. Can you text me your address? Here's her watch. Can you take that to her?
Yeah.
And then tell her if she needs it sized to just take it by the office tomorrow.
Okay.
And somebody will size it for her. All right, watches. Clothes, book, water. All right, I think I'm ready. I'm off to LA. The watch for the flight is gonna be none other than my Patek 5990 blue dial. Absolutely obsessed with this watch. Oh, I bought another AP. An offshore, I think you'll like it. You guys can see it when it comes in. It comes in next week. But it's extremely hard to find, extremely rare. I've been looking for it for like 3 weeks, and finally, out of the blue, because I continuously post it, someone called me and said they found one, and they sold it to me pretty cheap, actually. So.
Did you grab mine?
Your what?
Watch.
Yeah, it's in my bag.
Okay.
All right, see you guys in LA. Gotta move all that stuff. Just move it to the back seat, and then I got mask. You know what I'm saying? More books.
I guess that doesn't help either.
Why don't you put that in the back?
I know with a Lamborghini spoiler and his trunk of his T-Way.
You never know. Dude, that's a sexy car. Darby.
Was Darby just standing here smoking?
No, we were filming a commercial.
Oh, for the...
Yeah. Can't say. I'm still filming. Sorry, guys. I can't tell you what it's for. TSA free?
Yeah.
F*** you.
Do you go to first class the same way?
Nah, they don't have first class. I don't think.
Okay.
Alright, that's TSA.
I don't know, do they check that?
Yeah. know. Keep telling me how amazing TSA PreCheck is. You know I'm a felon. I can't get it. Oh, that's kind of cool.
Oh, damn, that's sad.
You hungry?
A little bit.
Me too. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
We have some time too. They get big boards like
that. Damn, I need some coffee. Not there though.
They
a little bit of fuel for the flight, so we can work. This guy's on work duty the whole time.
Sir,
you know, buddy.
Yeah. Thank you.
I realized how hard it was to try and film and do
this. Oh, yeah, right?
And hold luggage at the same time.
You know what I need? I need one of those suitcases that walk
around. Oh, yeah, that
roll, like, right next to your phone.
Yeah, they have, like, the thing in your pocket. You keep something in your pocket. Yeah. They have golf carts like that.
Like that?
Yeah. Yeah. Or golf carriers or whatever.
Takes a whole new level of that brings a whole new level of lazy to golf.
Oh yeah.
Like golf's already like the laziest sport ever.
I wouldn't say it's the laziest sport ever.
Pretty lazy. Think about all the rich people's sports. Badminton. No, not badminton. Croquet.
That's golf. Pretty lazy.
It's literally what can I play with the least amount of athletic ability.
Polo's pretty serious.
Polo, yeah, that's
polo's pretty serious.
That's like Uber or stuff. Not just golf. Golf, you only have to be rich. Polo, you have to be like stupid rich.
I'm in
okay. A what row?
5A.
Right here?
Thank you.
L.
Oh, you're on that side.
Seatbelt should be fastened whenever you're seated, just in case of unexpected turbulence. To get us on our way, make sure your seat is up, all electronic devices are put away, and your tray table is stowed. If you have a carry-on, push it all the way under the seat in front of you. If it won't fit, place it in the overhead bin.
All right, we gotta go get on the shuttle to 6.
Okay.
Three bottles of little Jack and Coke.
Jeez.
Well, hope you're in work mode now.
Yeah. YouTubing. Give us a show. Come on. You can't commit to it if you're not going to do it.
What the fuck?
Yes, we're copying that. Do me a favor. Drop and roll.
Oh shit, the card just lowered. That was cool. How do I get the mirror to... How do I get the mirror to go out?
Oh, push it.
No, because that one's on... It's automatic.
Are you sure?
Yeah. What the hell?
No.
Oh. Well, I thought I was going to break it. It's my favorite sushi place, guys. That sushi. Do what?
It's better than Odo.
Dude, it's, yeah.
Really?
It's pretty good.
Damn, okay. We have a sushi place in Frisco.
Oh, is it a limit? It's not a limited menu, is it?
He said it was with us.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's good. Oh my gosh. What's your first impression looking at it?
Pretty good. You see by the taste if it's better than Odo.
I'm gonna go ahead and say it is.
Really?
From what I remember.
That's big coming
through.
Dude.
Yeah.
I think we went to a couple last time we came here.
There's one, there's this guy, Patrick.
Yeah,
once you watch that, he's like 10 minutes from here. And then you can get down to Newport pretty quickly from here too.
This one's
the Yellowtail right here, right?
Yeah, that's Yellowtail. Look at that.
How's everything so far? Everything okay?
Excellent. Excellent. Ready?
Yeah.
You good?
Good.
Thank you for dinner once again, Imran. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Very, very good. Always good. All right, dude.
All right, dude.
I'll see you in the morning for the gym.
Yeah.
7:30.
7:30.
Alfred, you coming? that's a joke. I'm just kidding. All right,
guys. I've been wanting to tell you something this whole time. I'm just scared to tell you.
What's that?
I don't want to bite myself in the ass.
What were you going to tell me?
I wanted to start working out.
Yeah?
But no. See? No.
What? Come
see,
on. Don't. Well, you're going now. Don't bitch out now. Damn, you asshole.
Jeez. Not cool enough.
What?
Not cool enough.
I know, right? It was in like 12th gear.
It was like Audi A3 or
that was two. The fastest Honda Civic I've seen since we've been here. Oh, there's... Oh, of course, the bike. Damn it. Sit over here.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Dude,
it's a nice enough car. You can park with a dick. You saw that AP?
What?
You saw that AP.
I gotta check my messages right now. Working out in the morning, so I'll text you when I'm up.
All
right. Later. That you can't figure out how to turn the lights on. Oh, maybe that's it. There we go. Okay, well, it's not terrible. All right, so I just finished up a little dinner meeting here in Long Beach. We've checked into our hotel. Alfred's calling it a night. I got one more workout to do. It's about 10:25 in the evening, so I've got an hour and 35 minutes to knock out my hour-long outside workout, so I'm gonna get it done right now. Now, the cool thing, I haven't seen it yet, but they did tell me the gym was on the first floor, so I'm hoping they have like an outside connected area to the gym where I can, you know, sneak some weights outside and do a pretty cool workout, because just doing a jog or just doing a walk is kind of boring to me, so I'm hoping I can do something with some weights, so we'll see.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap. Day 8, 75 hard, workout number 2. Let's see. It's actually pretty nice. Not a bad little view to be working out to, but just so y'all can see that I'm out here, I'm gonna turn this off, turn it back on. It's 11:35, Friday, November 29th. It's almost midnight, pushing it close. Like I said, I got out here at 10:30, did an hour workout. You know, the whole 30 minutes leading up to coming out here, as they were driving up to the hotel, checking in, walking up to my room, of course you have all those normal thoughts of, nobody will know, you know, I can just check in on the app and who's really gonna know? And then you try to start talking yourself out of it, making all the excuses why you can't do it. And I went through all that, but you know, I go through all those talks knowing I'm still gonna do it because I made a promise to myself. I made a challenge. I made a commitment to you guys out there and I'm not gonna let anybody down. But even aside from all you, I'm not doing this for you guys. I'm doing it for me to prove that I can. And so, you know, for anyone out there that's doing this challenge or considering doing this challenge, I'm gonna tell you, leading up to something like this, when it's the end of the day and you're pushing it close to the wire, or you're tired, exhausted, I've gotta be up at 5 a.m. tomorrow to do another workout, and then I've got a 7-hour tattoo session. It's just work, man. Get through the first 15 minutes and it's gonna suck. But after you hit like that, it's weird. After you hit that 15 minute threshold, your body gets like this high, and you just do 5 more minutes and then do 5 more minutes. And I actually had a couple people walking around. One girl came out here and sat down for a minute and talked on the phone, and you know, I can't help but feel like maybe she was watching, getting some motivation, seeing like who's this douchebag out here working out at 11 o'clock at night. I don't know. Whoops, hang on. But anyway, it's 11:40 and I'm done. And I knocked out day 8. And I'm another day closer to my goal. So guys, I hope y'all are loving the channel. I'm loving doing it. I love reading the comments of how many people are getting inspired by me doing something like this for myself. I love that. Guys, comment below. If you're doing the 75 hard challenge, whether you just started or you started when I started, comment below. Let me know what day you're on. Let me know what the toughest part so far is with the challenge. And let's keep each other motivated. Guys, it's another day in my life. Tomorrow I've got a tattoo session I'm excited about to get the first half of the rest of my sleeve done, or the third half, I don't know, whatever. But guys, it's been a great day. It's been a long day. I'm tired. I'm gonna call it a night. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Oh, hey, don't forget about the Rolex competition. Like this post, share it across social media, come back and let me know where you shared it in the bottom in the comments below. And one lucky winner, once I hit 20,000 subscribers, is gonna win a Rolex Submariner. So, see you guys tomorrow.